Mary Jocelyn Philip of Montfendu, who resided at Madea St. Patrick and in London, England, passed away on Friday 29th March 2024 at the age of 80. She was the mother of Suzanne, Christina and Debbie Alexis in London, England, mother-in-law of Sunny Croucher in England, sister of Victor and Dennis Batiste, sister-in-law of Leonard Batiste, Lynthia English and Clarice Charles of Grenada, and Nugent Hackshaw, aunt of many including Vernon, Raymond, Yvonne, Judith, David and Gary Alexander and family in the UK, Gillian Alexis, Glenford, Elvin, Gavin Batiste and family, Darian Cajou and family in Grenada, Debbie, Jennifer Philip and family, Lystra Batiste, Anthea English and family in Canada, Laverne, Keith Batiste in the USA, Kim Williams, Nixon and Wendy Ann English in Grenada. Many cousins, other relatives and friends including Dinah Mark and family, Eslin and family, Velda Glasson and family, Vitalis Thomas and family, Clifton Paul and the Paul family of Rosehill, Raymond Philip and family, Verna Coutain and the Coutain family, the Philip family of Monkridge, Father Michael of St. Patrick's RC Church, and friends and neighbours of Madeys and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Mary Jocelyn Philip of Montfendu, who resided at Madeys St. Patrick and in London, England, will take place on Tuesday, June 18th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Sotheys RC Church and interment will be at the Churchyard Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home.
Sebastian McIntyre, also known as Bajack, Sibo and Bedman of Upper Capital, Brushgrove St. Andrew, died on Monday 27th May at the age of 70. Left to mourn his brothers Clifford, Avon, Wilmot and Roland McIntyre, sister Sherma Carmichael, brother-in-law Dexter Carmichael, sister-in-law Joan McIntyre, aunt Agatha, Magdalene and Frances, uncles Francis, Anthony and Hilary, many nieces and nephews too numerous to mention, many other relatives and friends including Nolene Henry and family, the McIntyre family, the Lyons family, the Powlett family, the Moore family, Abby and Ali David, Trevor Jeffrey and family, Michelle Bernard, the Boys by Luther Sharp, the Charles family, Anella John and family, Jacinta Peters and family, Sharon Felix and family, the market vendors, fishermen, fish vendors, fish cleaners of Grenville and Miss Rose Perrott, the Conjax vendors in Grenville. The funeral of the late Sebastian McIntyre, also known as Bajack, Sibo and Bedman, will take place on Tuesday, 18th June at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Brushgrove Roman Catholic Church and interment will be at the St. Rose Cemetery, Brushgrove. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home.
George Nicholas Johnson, also known as Scratch and Nico of St. Paul St. George, former employee of Telephone Communication, Grentel and Cable and Wireless, passed away on Tuesday, 28th May 2024, at the age of 71. He was the husband of Christine Johnson, father of Nicole Johnson and Nicolin Johnson, grandfather of Nicholas Jr. Johnson and Angel Johnson, brother of Michael Alexis in Canada, Terry Cadet, Carol Pear, Yvonne Pipper, Jenny Alexis and Jennifer Franklin, all in the USA, Lawrence Lewis, Dave, Esau, Mabel, Dallin and Alfred Pear, Kester Williams, Gemma Mitchell, and Hilary Joseph in Grenada, brother-in-law of Jeffrey Franklin and Jerome Worm in the USA, DeCosta Worm in Puerto Rico, Christopher Andrews, Dunbar Andrews, Arthur Noel, Barbara Andrews, Suzanne Pear, Cynthia Alexis, Joyce Lewis, Suzanne Worm, Catherine Pear, Deborah Pear, Dawn Andrews in the USA, and Helen Alexis in Canada, nephew of Peter Johnson. Many nieces and nephews in Canada, the USA, and Grenada, including Kathy Victor, Mike and Roger Alexis, and Adonna Lewis. Other relatives and friends including Letitia Johnson in Switzerland, Kathleen Arnold, Peter Johnson, Magnus Felix and family, David Telesford and family, Martha Noel and family, Magdalene James, Berlin Charles, Lincoln Basden and family, Sam James, James Stewart and family, Catherine Langine, Lindley Edwards, Fitzroy August and family, MacDonald Bullen, Cicely Cyrus, Governor-General Dame Cecilia Grenard, Hilary Gabriel and family, the Robinson and Noel families, Simone Francis in the USA, the boys at Otway's Bar, and neighbors and friends of Park Estate, St. Paul's and surrounding areas, the USA, Canada, St. Vincent, Dominica and Carriacou. The funeral of the late George Nicholas Johnson, also known as Cratch and Nico, of St. Paul St. George, will take place on Wednesday, June 19th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the People's Church St. Paul's and entombment will be at the Mount Airy Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Phyllis Teresa Caliste of Mount Rose St. Patrick passed away on Monday, May 20th, 2024, at the age of 83. She was the sister of Mickey, Valerie, Kenneth, Enos, Doreen, Francis, also known as Manny, Frederick, Orvis, Myrtle, Margaret, Phyllis, and Chriselle. Sister-in-law of Cindy, Nan, and Cheryl, Hernando, and Joseph. Aunt of many, including Fallon, Melissa, Debbie, Hanif, Sharon, Tiffany, Sheena, Lauren, Michael, Angela, and Christopher. Her caregivers, Miss Johanna Caliste and Miss Christine. Other relatives and friends, including Dennis, Desmond, Jeanette, Donald, Jude, Miss Leslie, Poyo, Miss Ella, the Caliste family of Mount Rose, the Bowler and Ramdani families, and friends and neighbors of Mount Rose, Latast, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Phyllis Teresa Caliste of Mount Rose St. Patrick will take place on Thursday, June 20th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Tivoli RC Church St. Andrew, and interment will be at the Family Cemetery Mount Rose. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home.
Claire Mary Joseph, also known as Mammy Jo, of Belmont St. George, passed away on Tuesday, 21st May, at the age of 88. She was a mother of Anthony, also known as Moon, Cheryl Ann Dunbar, Stephen, also known as Levy, Lauriston, also known as Larry, and Hilda Miller. Grandmother of Dally, Sabrina, Leah, Liana, Dwayne, Jonathan, Keegan, Jelaine, Alexa, Akiba, Kimber, Donnet, and Reese. Great-grandmother of Kiara, Keita, Kenzo, Hendrick, and Liam. Sister of Hamilton Roger, Catherine Odell, Margaret Skerritt, Clyde, Victor, and Hannah Daniel, and Clyde Charles. Mother-in-law of Earl Dunbar, Brian Strawn, Paul Miller, Teresa, and Julian Joseph. Several nieces and nephews including Louise Riley, Renee, Crystal, Natalie, Roxanne, Solange, Sean, Kino, Jennifer and Richard Joseph, and Robert Branch. Sisters and brothers-in-law, many other relatives and friends including Rachel Ferguson and family, Pat Henry and family, Faith Cox and family, Michael Filbert and family, Imo Philip and family, Margaret Nathan, Cynthia Hood and family, Juliana Greenidge, Dennis James, Otley family, Clara Bell and family, Pascal family, Sheila Noel, Norma Wilson and family, Regis and Doreen Miller and family, Antilk Evans, Elma Donnell and family, Sheila and Richard Frank and family, Mary Inc., Strawn family, Jimmy Smith, also known as Old Brick, Cyril Simon and family, Phil Bain, the Congregation of Our Lady, Queen of Peace, Roman Catholic Church, Belmont, friends and neighbors of Belmont and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Mary Claire Joseph of Belmont St. George will take place on Thursday, 20th June at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Blessed Sacrament Catholic Church, Grandin St. George, and entombment will be at the Grandin Cemetery. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lacour Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lacour Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Pastor Terence Gibbon, also known as Brother Ter, of Redmud, St. Patrick, who resided at Fontaine, St. Mark, pastor of Christian Fellowship Church, Redmud, and former employee of the Grenada Bottling Company, passed away on Saturday, 18th May, at the age of 70. He was the husband of Myrtlyn Gibbon, father of Perry Gibbon, Richard Gibbon, and Makeda Bartholomew, great-grandfather of Chaley McLeish, Rihanna, Enrique, and Tyler Gibbon and Nalani Cyrus, brother of Joan John, Sion John, and Deborah John Lewis in the USA, Keith Narayan and Daphne Gibbons in Trinidad, Hanif Gibbons and Annie Cox in England, Stephanie John in Puerto Rico, father-in-law of Siobhan Gibbon and Matthew Bartholomew, brother-in-law of Leroy, Hanson, Daniel, and Gladys Dixon. Many nieces and nephews including Donald John, Christy Lewis, Andrew Dixon, Lucia Narayan, Kenny Dixon, and Sandra Charles. Many other relatives and friends including Trevor, Enroy, Raul, Rohan, Angus, Pastor Augustine, Charles and family, the Narayan, Ratu, Eli, Fletcher, Chitterman, and Knight's families, members of the Christian Fellowship Assembly, friends and neighbors of Redmud, Fountain, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Pastor Terence Gibbon of Redmud, who resided at Fountain St. Mark, will take place on Friday, 21st June at 12 noon. Funeral service will be held at the Christian Fellowship Assembly, Redmud St. Patrick, and entombment will be at the family cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lockwood Brothers Funeral Home. Bernadette Peters of Brush Grove St. Andrew passed away on Thursday, 13th June, at the age of 60. The funeral for the late Bernadette Peters of Brush Grove St. Andrew will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lockwood Brothers Funeral Home. Roger Williams Paul, also known as Boss of Queen Street, Victoria St. Mark, passed away on Friday, 7th June, at the age of 53. The funeral of the late Roger Williams of Queen Street, Victoria St. Mark, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to Lockwood Brothers Funeral Home.
Stephen Wilton Decoto of Wharf St. John, who resided in Longwood, Florida, USA, and at Spice Care Facility, Morris Bishop Highway, Grand Anse, St. George, passed away on Wednesday, June 12, 2024, at the age of 86. The funeral arrangements for the late Stephen Wilton Decoto of Wharf St. John, who resided in Longwood, Florida, USA, and at the Spice Care Facility, Morris Bishop Highway, Grand Anse, St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Jocelyn Catherine Simon, also known as Mae West and Miss Lacqua, of Chantimel, St. Patrick, passed away on Friday, 31st May 2024, at the age of 92. The funeral arrangements for the late Jocelyn Catherine Simon, also known as Mae West and Miss Lacqua, of Chantimel, St. Patrick, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Hilda Bernice James, also known as BJ, of Trinidad, who resided at Crochet St. Andrew and Latonde St. David, passed away on Friday, 24th May 2024, at the age of 79. The funeral arrangements for the late Hilda Bernice James, also known as BJ, of Trinidad, who resided at Crochet St. Andrew and Latonde St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Rose Shirley Noel of Fontenoy St. George, who resided at Bonaire St. Mark, passed away on Sunday, 26th May 2024, at the age of 82. The funeral arrangements for the late Rose Shirley Noel of Fontenoy St. George, who resided at Bonaire St. Mark, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
I'm Pastor Jerry Keynes Douglas, and I'd like to take the opportunity today to express my deepest sympathy to all of you who have lost loved ones, friends, members of your family or inner circle. Probably one of the hardest issues to deal with in life is the loss of a loved one, someone close. There is arguably no harder blow than to be separated from someone as a result of death, and especially so when that death has come as a tragedy, as a tragic circumstance. Our deepest sympathy is with you today. I'd like to share a word of comfort with you from the Word of God that we can all learn from as we deal with bereavement, with mourning, with sorrow, and with the pain of a lost loved one. I'd like to say from the Word of God, we learn about Abraham, the patriarch. And the Bible says that when Abraham's wife, Sarah, died in Hebron, that Abraham sat down to mourn and to weep for her. And then after a period of mourning and weeping, the Bible says Abraham arose and he went to do business, to buy land, to build a tomb for Sarah, and to bury her remains. And for all of us, there is that issue of dealing with the grieving period. And yes, it's okay to mourn, it is okay to grieve, it is okay to express that sense of loss and the pain that it comes with it. But I say to you today, you're not alone. Like Abraham, go ahead and mourn. You're not alone. It's natural, let it happen. However, I also believe that by the grace of God, you're not alone in these times. So God says, and as you feel that pain, he says, come to me, all ye that are heavy laden, burdened and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. We need to come to him and find a grace that goes beyond the casual comfort that people may give to us. Find support in God himself. I also want to say to you that if you mourn and you know your loved one knew the Lord, you know the Lord, then we do not mourn as those who have no hope, but we know that Jesus will come again and the dead in Christ shall arise. That ought to be your hope as well. But finally, I also want to say to you in this difficult time to focus on what your loved one would have wanted. The Bible says Abraham rose up after his mourning, even during that, and he was able to get on with his life. And your loved ones would certainly want you to go through some grief and some mourning, but also to be able to move on with your life and to do the things that they would want you to do, to be strong, to bounce out of your grief and to be able to carry on and to fulfill the rest of your life until the day comes when you or I would be inevitably moved out of here by the same process. So my prayers are with you today, that God would help you and give you comfort and grace in this time of bereavement. May the Lord bless you and help you and strengthen you in an amazing way. And as I close, I give you this wonderful promise from God's word. He says, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. He says, I will strengthen you, I will help you, and I will support you with my mighty right hand. Isaiah 41:10. May God bless you.